Welcome to PJ's Q&A section. Hello everyone, my YouTube subscriber Henry Palominos sent me this cat model. He's trying to make this class ring and having trouble to get the foam flow really well. So let's talk about how I will change the way to model to make it flow better to the center and turning into something like this. So first, what I like to do is I will suggest everybody put your model right in the center for 0, 0, because anything you want to do symmetrical, it's much easier to mirror with the align with all the construction plan. So the next things I wanted to do is we need to rebuild this one. I will try to follow the shank as close as possible, but I will do a little bit change right here. This is the point where it's coming into really pointed here. If you're going to fill it later, you're going to have problem. So I will suggest you to having something a little bit rounder, coming up instead of coming up really pointed there. Then you will have a less surface issue, and we can try to match the rest of them as close as possible. So something like that. The second line we're going to have is kind of starting from this point and going up like that. Okay, so those are the two lines. We are going to do one thing first. We want to project it to the construction plan because they may not be flat and we want to delete the input. So this is what you see on my there. Okay, the second thing is I'm going to delete the ring. Now we have those line and we need to have this line follow our ring shank. So the command we're gonna use is the curve from the two view, 1 and 2, and then you get this one. And we're gonna do one more time. This is 1, this is 2, and then we get that one. Let me also move it up. I always like to have the ring shank, like center of the ring is aligned to the 0. So one more time, we need to move it up a little bit. Okay, so now we have this. We don't need the bottom of the ring shank, so I'm going to use the split command with the point, and we want to split it right at a quadrant. Same thing over here, we want to use the split command with the point and split right at the quadrant or midpoint there. So we want to delete the one on the bottom. Okay, so now we have this curve. We don't longer need this one. Let's hide it. So now this is the new curve that we have. I'm going to creating the profile there. So I'm just simply just using the rectangle here and something gonna look like this. And we also want to create another rectangle there, but coming into the right view so we can make it match to the high over here. So I'm going to moving this into other layer. So let's turn off this, just looking at the curve right now. We're going to creating the surface by going to sweep to rail 1, rail 2, cross section and cross section. Make sure you record the history, and then we can click on that, make sure the arrow is aligned and the facing the same direction. So now we have this one there. Let's turn on the center part so it will fit much better there. And if you don't like the shape, you might want this go higher or lower. You can actually turn on the control point and let's say I want that point go a little bit higher like this way. At the same time, you are changing the thickness right there. Okay, we can do all kind of adjustment until we feel like this is the ring that we wanted to have. So we want to make sure it is completely intersect and the one in the middle is apparently a little bit too short. So I'm going to use the gumbo, hold on the control and shift. Let's click on this surface and also this surface. Alright, so what we're gonna do is we are going to extrude it, make sure they are completely intersect with the whole ring shank. Okay, then we are going to use the bowl length split. This red one will be split by this center one. Now we can delete where to intersect and have it completely fit in there. So next step, we can have this one using the rotate tool. Make sure copy equal yes, and now we can snap it into the zero and rotate it to the other side, so we'll have this offset ring shank there. On the bottom of the ring shank, we already have one curve over there, so all we need to do is to duplicate it the edges right here and make sure you join them, and we can use the sweep one, go from here to here, and that's how we create the bottom of the ring shank. So now everything is done, we need to trim off the extra that we created from the middle part. So we're going to extrude it the planar curve straight, and then we can bowling difference the middle part out of this cylinder. So that will be the ring for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and comment, and let me know if you have other questions. When you send an email to me, please also send your model. Let me know what is the most difficult part so that I can help you more accurately. Thank you for watching. I will see you next.